Hey guys, welcome to another episode of Section 8 Real Estate Investing. I'm Rhett. Today we're going to talk about buying property online. Now this goes for a lot of different kinds of property, okay? Not just Section 8 property in particular, all right? This goes from being an out-of-state investor, buying a property online in a different state where you're not there. This also, we're talking about buying auction property, right? A lot of really, really good ways that you guys at home can buy property out of state in your state via an auction website, right? There's auction.com, there's Exome, there's Hubzoo. There's a lot of different ways that you can buy property online, and the only due diligence sometimes you can do is through pictures, right? So let's talk about that a little bit, okay? Because there are some big problems with that, all right? Now, the price is not always equal to the product, okay? Now, what I mean by that is there might be a price that's really low, and that house and those pictures looks really good. And if it's too good to be true, a lot of times it is, all right? Especially with real estate. If you can't get to the property and do your own due diligence in person, guys, spend $50, spend $100, reach out to somebody there, talk to a realtor, go online, go to Facebook groups, see if there are any bird dogs in that area, somebody with boots on the ground, maybe you have a friend that lives in that area. Reach out to somebody, get pictures inside that unit, okay? Send somebody down there, take a video walkthrough for you, all right? Anything you can do to verify that the price of that unit is worth what you're getting for it. Quick story, I went to a property one time, looking through it, place looked great. It was very affordable. Walking through it, and I was like, wow, this place is awesome. Where's the kitchen? And as I walked to the end of the hallway, I opened a door and I was in the backyard. It was a meth lab and the entire back of the house blew off, right? The only way I know that is because I went down and looked. It was in a different state. I drove 3.5 hours to go check it out. Good thing I did, otherwise I would have been out of pocket a lot of cash, all right? So send somebody down there, okay? Because the only pictures I saw are pictures of the front of the unit and the first three rooms, bedroom, bathrooms. Oof, be careful. All right, guys, REO versus for sale by owner, real estate owned, okay? And what I mean by that is a lot of banks. Okay, bank owned is REO, okay? So, is it an auction property? Is it listed? Now there's a difference, okay? The difference is, if it is a listed property, it's represented by an agent, okay? An agent has information on that property. An agent's in touch with the seller of that property. There's information that you can receive, that you can get from the seller, all right? Now if it's an auction, their information is very limited. Okay, a lot of times banks come into possession of these properties through foreclosures, and there's just not a lot of info. They take their properties, they give them to an auction broker, all right? That broker then auctions the property off, okay? That auctioneer company auctions the property off. There's not a lot of information. A lot of times you don't know what kind of liens are on the property, okay? You don't know what kind of title you're gonna be inheriting. You don't know if you're gonna be inheriting tenants. All right, so this is very important to know, all right? For sale by owner, same thing. You don't know what kind of title you're getting. At least if it comes from a bank, you know that title's probably gonna be clean. Now there might be liens on it, and that's something that you're gonna have to go over in a title check. But a lot of times I like buying real estate owned from banks because at least I know that a bank is going to hand me over a clear title, meaning there aren't gonna be any big time liens against it. It'll be marketable, I'll have marketable title on that property, which means I'll be able to turn around and sell that property, okay? There isn't gonna be anything big against that property that's gonna hinder me if I wanna flip it, turn it around and sell it, or do anything with it, okay? Now, who are you dealing with in the purchase of this property? Who are you communicating with? Are you contacting, going through an agent who's listing the property, or are you going through a wholesaler? Now, there's a big difference here. Wholesalers, could be anyone. You don't need a license to be a wholesaler in most states. Meaning, say I wanna sell my rental portfolio. Someone comes up to me, a wholesaler goes, hey, listen, you give me this contract at $500,000, I'm gonna find a buyer. What they do is they take a buyer, they go out there, they look, and they have it under contract for $500,000, they try and sell it for $530,000. They make the spread, okay? Now, an agent takes a flat fee based on the sale price, right? A wholesaler is not licensed. They go out there, they try to push your product and make whatever spread. If they sell it for $600,000 and you list it for $500,000, they're taking that extra $100,000, okay? from what I, my experience, nothing against you wholesalers out there, okay? I know a lot of great wholesalers who do fantastic work and sell hundreds of properties a year, but my trust lays more with agents. You know, there's a, there is a process here, okay? There is a license process. There is a lot more integrity here than there is there, all right? Guys, liens, title, and occupants are the three biggest things that people run into when they buy properties online, okay? Even if you find a house that might be undervalued for an area that it's in, it might seem really good. It could have tons of liens on it. And when I say liens, it could have municipal liens from the city. It could have sewer liens. It could have water bills. Now guys, this stuff, it could have fines, right? I bought a property a couple years ago that had, it was fined every single day that a window was open on the first floor, okay? It was fined $30 a day for 3 years. Do that math. It's not fun when you come into a property like that and you're the one, the new buyer, has to pay those liens, okay, before you close on it. You're in a really rough spot because sometimes if you back out of a deal, you lose your earnest money, all right? The title, what kind of liens are on it? What's on it? Are there other mortgages on there? What other liens are on it, guys? Make sure you get a clear title, okay? And lastly, occupants. When you buy property online sometimes, they're occupants. Now, whether they've been there for a year and haven't paid rent and are squatting in the property, or whether they're great rent-paying tenants, knowing who the occupants are is very important, and knowing if there are occupants is incredibly important. And a lot of times, you're swinging in the dark on these three things when you buy properties online, all right? So if you learn anything today, do your due diligence. If you find something online that seems a little too good to be true, it probably is, contact an agent in that area, get as much information on that property as possible, okay? Being from out of state, it's hard to do that. Reach out to people on the ground there, get pictures, get videos if possible. Okay, if it has occupants, it's probably not gonna be allowed, but do your due diligence, okay? The worst thing you can do is pull the trigger on a property online, put $5,000 down earnest money, realize it's got $25,000 in old liens and judgments from the person who lived there before you who got sued, right, on the property. It's got a bad title, it's not marketable, which means you can't turn it around and sell the property after you do updates to it, and it has occupants that don't wanna leave. Guys, thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, like. We got a lot of good stuff coming at you. Thanks for your time.